Units are clear. Emergency lights and sirens. Units in the motorcade, switch to a stagger.
Are we doing a stagger?
Your favorite was run normal.
Thank you.
Approaching final point. Units outside of K9. Go ahead and park on West Eclipse Boulevard. Disable emergency equipment and park on West Eclipse Boulevard. Any further units can hold position. Park where you're at, please. Please disable emergency equipment and make your way inside. Units surround the pond.
We thank you and welcome you to the memorial service for Joey T. by David 204. Honor Guard, please make your way to the island. All units stand by for final call.
San Andreas calling 5D-204, Joey T. San Andreas calling 5D-204, Joey T. This is the final call for 5D-204, badge number 152. 628. End of watch is 8:20 of 2024. Joey, a friend, a hero, a brother, a son. Joey, thank you for all the memories and love you gave to so many. My friend, May you rest in peace as we take it from here until we see you again on the other side. We love you. San Andreas is clear. 2346.
Honor Guard, present arms. Units, present arms.
Steady. Aim. Fire. Steady. Aim. Fire. Steady. Aim. Fire. Honor Guard at ease.
Detail, order, arms.
Good evening. My name is Chief Master Trooper Daniel J. I am a supervisor of San Andreas High Patrol K-9 Unit. I am speaking today on behalf of our K-9 Unit Coordinator, Sergeant Andrew N., who could not be here this evening. The following comes directly from him. Quote, Joey was a very respected handler within our unit. Joey joined the K-9 Unit March 15th, 2022, quickly working to become a trainer within the unit. Joey stayed very involved with teaching the newest members of the unit. Through July of 2023, we made the decision to dedicate his love towards the supervisor position within CVE and become an honorary member of the unit. Even still, he continued to patrol with his friends within the unit and held trainings from time to time to help everybody out. Joey made lots of friends within the unit, and we've missed greatly. In recognition of his love and efforts into this unit, by the power invested in me as the K-9 coordinator, I hereby relieve K-9 Angelo from his duties and thank him for his 2.5 years of service to the department. May your retirement be filled with many belly rubs, games of fetch, and a few extra treats. In addition, hereby retire your name to preserve the honor of you and your handler, K-9 Angelo, 10-7, 10-42 for the final time. Thank you for your service.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for coming. I'm Highway Sergeant Zachary A, 28, also known as 5 Tango 28, 5 Mary 28, and currently coordinator of the Bureau of Transportation and Enforcement Aggressive Driving Apprehension Team. Joey, my buddy, my fellow supervisor, the CVE guy, and my teammate, who I've known for 2 years, a bright individual with a big heart, who I've been working with side by side in the Bureau of Transportation and Enforcement as a fellow supervisor before my promotion to coordinator. Somebody I've known so much about and so little time. I wish I could have said more and could have done more within the time we had, but you were a very bright, smart individual. Knowing the commercial vehicle enforcement on the other side of Bureau of Transportation Enforcement on the back of his hand. Training me to who I am currently, holding my CDL certification and the CVE certifications that CVE currently holds. There's not much to say for you, Joey, but I wish our time could have lasted longer. It was a pleasure working for you, and you will always be known to my fellow supervisors as well as the aggressive driving apprehension team patrolling by your side. We will still continue to patrol by your side and uphold the duties that you were sworn to uphold. Joey, once again, I thank you for your time and the Bureau and HP and the community as a whole, and I wish I could see you again. Until we meet again, Joey.
My name's Gerald. I met Joey when I first started here at DOJ, and it's just hard to believe that he's definitely gone. And Joey is the kind of person that, honestly, when I look back at why I dove deeper into my career, if you would, here at DOJ, a lot of that is credited to Joey. Joey's the kind of person that was always good to make you laugh. Joey's the kind of person that would do whatever he could to help you move along, whether it be, you know, staying up late with you and just helping you study for stuff or whatever it might be. Like, Joey was just always that guy that was just helping everyone. It's because of Joey that I met a lot of you. Joey, outside of what he did here, was just a hero. Like, he, even through everything that he went through, he still served people. So that wasn't just something that he did here, but it was just who he was all around. So, Joey, you'll be missed, my friend. And we just hope to be half the man that you were. So, love you, Joey.
I'm Tom T. I'm currently the CDE coordinator. Joey was beyond someone that you could ever ask as a friend. He was not only someone that I would talk to, not only when he was not in the greatest place mindset-wise, but also those times that he wasn't the happiest. He was in a hospital room or trying to be the best person he could be. I've spent so many endless hours on the phone with him trying to keep his mindset high, and we've had some really good conversations, but he also was the best person to help you in any situation, no matter if it's within the community, but also personality wise. He was the person that made me the person I am now. He got me all of my certifications, as well as CDL, as well as helped me be the best supervisor and now coordinator that I could have been. Joey, you'll be greatly missed. And we will always keep you in our memories.
Looking back at the messages I had with Joey, the times that I met him back, the early and late nights of December 2021, the first time that my mom found she had cancer. I can't believe it's been that long. The time we spent patrolling, the long 12-hour patrols, John, Zach, Buckeye, Speedo, Cameron, Cade, Tom. I could go on a long list. But at the end of the day, is after those 12-hour patrols, we decided at the end of the patrol just to get on to play another game until we patrol again. Those were the days. The days we would be in Discord call, even at the times we wouldn't even talk, just knowing we were there for each other no matter what. What he will be with us at times when it's tough, even when it's tough for him. Just know he is looking down at all of us. We will always be brothers, and we'll always be there for him, no matter what. I keep waiting for him to pop in the Discord and hear his voice. Keep waiting for him to message me and ask if I'm in queue, waiting for him to ask when my days are off, and also him always asking me and Buckeye and everyone else, how's our day going, even if he's having the worst days. Waiting to see pictures, waiting to say good morning, waiting to say good night, no matter what, he was always a brother. We all gave him so much crap about everything, and he was always a hose dragger. But at the end of the day, he was always our friend, our brother. As you guys know, we've all known Joey several years now. In that time, he's been constant in our life. Texting, Discord, DoJ, everything else. DoJ is a family, as everyone says, but at the end of the day, it's always going to be there for us, and we always have people at the end of the day. All I can say is Joey became a CVE supervisor. He worked well with a lot of people, good or bad, mutual support. He supported the team and put countless hours, and even when hospitalized, he was on his phone and still replying to the messages and answering questions when he can. He was not just our best friend, he was our brother. And he would have had long conversations about everything and everything, giving any advice he can, even if he had no idea what he was talking about. I remember a time I was talking to him on the phone after a call and just getting off a tough call. I called him, and what do? I hear him yelling at the nurse because he couldn't get food that someone snuck in. But who cares? He's always there. He's not selfish. He always put others before him in everything he did. He was one of a kind, so never forget the amazing impact he had on my life and everyone else. He was our friend, our brother, my buddy, our homie. I love you, man. I miss you. I know it's hard to say, but 204, we got you. Fly high, always.
Good evening. I am Commissioner Greg C. 5-Echo-1 of the San Andreas Highway Patrol. I want to thank everyone before me for their kind words to Senior Trooper Joey T. 5-Delta-204. I personally did not know Joey. However, myself and my command team have crossed paths multiple times when working closely with him and his command, working with him and his team within the Commercial Vehicle Enforcement Subdivision. Those who join a role-playing community such as the Department of Justice are looking for that escape from reality, a place to forget what is going on in the real world, a place to meet new people and build friendships. Today is one of those days that we wish we did not have to face. From the gathering today, you can see how much Joey meant to each and every person attending this memorial. From close friends to community members from every department who are showing their respect and support, to Joey's friends and family who may be watching from afar. This is what makes DOJRP family and a home away from home. To honor Joey's memory, his contributions to the community, and the impact he's had on his family and friends, the San Andreas Highway Patrol will be retiring his end-of-watch call sign, 5-Delta-204. In addition to this, I was told one of his favorite assets in our servers is the Camaro. A special ghosted highway patrol livery for this vehicle was created and will be on display throughout our servers at select locations to pay his respect throughout the month of September. Thank you all for your support, and remember to always be there for each other.
Hello. I am Adam M., former 7, one of the longest standing people that were alongside Joey, that came to DOJ. I came to DOJ initially, I didn't even realize I was going to reapply until after Joey had texted me one day excited that he got accepted into DOJ again. When I saw that message from him, I got excited on my own, because I had been thinking and contemplating it for a while back in 2021 and debated on joining DOJ once more. When he got accepted, I put mine in and got accepted, and we did our best to patrol every single day that we could together. From logging for the first few months of our time in DOJ, 100 hour plus months, and enjoying time late at night talking, doing anything that we could just to put smiles on each other's faces, and making sure that we had memories that were going to last a lifetime. I can say that he is one of my bestest friends. And he's also a part of my family. There's not a day that's gone by since this happened that I haven't thought of him. And the entire time I've done nothing but weep and cry because I miss my best friend, and I'm waiting just like everybody else behind me for that text message, for him to join Discord, for him to just yell my name one more time. Unfortunately, it's not going to happen. But on the bright side, at the end of everybody's life, people say that the last 7 minutes of your life excuse me, the last 7 minutes that your brain is active, your mind replays memories in your head. I hope I was a part of one of those fondest memories, because he definitely will be a part of mine. No matter how much that boy was hurting or how much pain he was in, he was always excited to talk to everybody on the phone, and I was excited to be there by his side no matter what he was going through. He pushed me to be a better person, and I did the same for him, or at least hope I did. I love you, Joey. I'll never forget you.
On behalf of everyone here, friends, family, and others alike, we thank you for coming to this event. Department of Justice community will never be the same without our friend, Joey. We appreciate everybody who has put forth effort towards this event, taking time out of their day to be here alongside us. It is great to see that a community such as this will stand together for brother in arms. Finally, Joey Tyndall, fly high, brother. Thank you all for those who have attended. You are free to leave at this time. We will handle your vehicles. Thank you once again, and have a great night and a great evening.
No, all right, folks. Sorry for being silent for so long, but felt like it was needed because this was an memorial to Joey. I myself did not know Joey, but he was, from what I've seen and heard, a great person to know and stuff like that. So I wanted to pay my respects to Joey, and the only way I really could to share it with the world what he meant to everybody, and then hopefully give him the respect that he deserved. So I know it's not the usual stream that I do, and I do apologize. Kind of like the 9/11 memorial that DOJ hosts, it's something of
partner, if you could please change your scenes, that would be greatly appreciated.
Yep. I'm gonna go ahead and mute that so they don't have to hear it, but that way if they do say anything. But yeah, that's just our respects for Joey. You know, he was a very revered member of the community, so I thank everyone who popped out to say, even if he didn't say anything, just to watch and pay your respects. I appreciate you. So I'm gonna go ahead and end my stream there, and I will see you the next time I stream.